Good morning. And as always, thank you for being here with us at Notre Dame. Today we're going to celebrate the Feast of the Transfiguration, and Mass will be celebrated for the repose of the soul of Father Matthew Reuschen. Father Matt was the pastor of St. Anthony's and Sharon and Our Lady of Fatima and Farrell, and he died a few days ago, and it's a great loss to the people of his parish. It's a great loss to us priests. He was a very friendly and wonderful guy, wonderful helper, and so lost to the people of God as a whole. So please keep him in your prayers. Let's begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who in the glorious transfiguration of your only begotten Son confirmed the mysteries of faith by the witness of the fathers and wonderfully prefigured our full adoption to sonship, grant, we pray, to your servants that, listening to the voice of your beloved Son, we may merit to become co-heirs with him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Daniel. As I watched, thrones were set up, and the Ancient One took his throne. His clothing was bright as snow, and the hair on his head as white as wool. His throne was flames of fire, with wheels of burning fire. A surging stream of fire flowed out from where he sat. Thousands upon thousands were ministering to him, and myriads upon myriads attended him. The court was convened, and the books were opened. As the vision during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the Ancient One and was presented before him, the one, like a son of man, received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages served him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth. The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth. The Lord is King. Let the earth rejoice. Let the many islands be glad. Clouds and darkness are round about him. Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne. The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth. The mountains melt like the wax before the Lord of all the earth. The heavens proclaim his justice, and all peoples see his glory. The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth. Because you, O Lord, are the Most High over all the earth, exalted far above all gods. The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth. A reading from the letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, we do not follow cleverly devised myths when we made known to you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but we have been eyewitnesses of his majesty. For he received honor and glory from God the Father when that unique declaration came to him from the majestic glory. This is my Son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased. We ourselves heard this voice come from heaven when we were with him on the holy mountain. Moreover, we possess the prophetic message that is altogether reliable. You will do well to be attentive to it, as to a lamp shining in a dark place, until day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Father, your blessing, please.
May Almighty God bless you, that you'll worthily proclaim the gospel in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus took Peter, James, and his brother John and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became white as light. And behold, Moses and Elijah appeared to him, conversing with him. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, Lord, it is good that we are here. If you wish, I will make three tents here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. While he was still speaking, behold, a bright cloud cast a shadow over them. And then from the cloud came a voice that said, This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. And when the disciples heard this, they fell prostrate and were very much afraid. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, Rise and do not be afraid. And when the disciples raised their eyes, they saw no one else but Jesus alone. And they were coming down from the mountain. Jesus charged them, Do not tell the vision to anyone until the Son of Man has been raised from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, hello and welcome this morning as we gather in the presence of our Savior Jesus Christ. What a great day it is, indeed, for today. We're reminded not only of the majesty of Jesus Christ himself, but of the presence of God in our world. You know, in this gospel, we have Jesus, our Savior, the New Testament, the Word made flesh. He's conversing with Moses and Elijah from the Old Testament. Moses representing the law, Elijah representing the prophets. And Jesus, in the presence of these great men, was so much more. And in fact, our scripture says, his face shone like the sun and his clothes became white. giving evidence of this is the giving evidence of his position in the Trinity, the God-man. Even more, God himself proclaims to Peter, James, and John without mincing words. He says that Jesus is the Son that brings him pleasure, and he commands the disciples to listen to Jesus. And by the way, we too have the same command to listen to Jesus. What wonderful imagery. It's just beautiful. I mean, our Savior is more than just a good man and a standout human being. He is God. He is God in the flesh. He is so much more. Amen to that. But we also need to think about how this event a couple of millennia ago impacts us in our day-to-day lives and our existence here in August of 2023. You know, we're all made in God's image. We're all called to be Christ-like, to be holy, to be good. My question is, how are you doing with that? And my guess is, some days you nail it. You just feel on fire. You've done well. And then maybe other days, and I've certainly felt this way, I have to ask myself at the end of the day, have I ever set foot in a church in my life? What the heck was that about? Thank goodness we worship a loving God, one that understands and offers the grace and mercy through the forgiveness of sins. He knows us. He knows us. And my encouragement to you today is to keep that in mind this week, in particular, as we celebrate and we feast the Transfiguration, to remember that we're not perfect beings. So don't focus on one event. Don't focus on even maybe a couple of events. Focus on the long game, on the journey of being a disciple, as opposed to those times where we fail. And let's take this another step further. If we're to be Christ-like in our discipleship, we need to be very aware that our actions reflect the transfigured Savior to the people around us. People see God, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, through interaction with us, his disciples. This is pretty complex stuff. I get it. But you know what? We're humans and we're perceptive beings, again, created in the image of God. So let me give you just a concrete example. Last year, Carrie and I picked up our granddaughter, our oldest granddaughter, Hayden, from an after-school function. And so we're gathered there with all a bunch of other parents and grandparents just waiting to pick up the children. And it was fun to watch the kids come out, and as they entered that room where all these people were, they quickly could recognize, there's my parent, there's my grandparent, there's this special bond. They recognized each other differently than all the rest in the group. And suddenly, here comes Hayden. I see her, she sees me, we exchange a smile. You know what? I didn't see just any teenager. I saw my teenager. She didn't see just some old lost fool trying to figure out where to pick up all the kids. She saw her lost fool that was trying to pick up the kids, her grandfather. And it was wonderful to see that, because in that instance, I could kind of get into the Transfiguration as a grandfather, as a father figure, and say, oh, there's my Hayden, and I'm so pleased to see her growing into the woman she's growing into. And on the other side of that, in the figure of the son, my granddaughter saying, I recognize him, he's my grandfather. You know, and she was so at ease in my presence and in the presence of others. And then there was the Holy Spirit. You know, that figure of the Holy Spirit that comes in the recognition that there's a special and sacred relationship between us. Yes, we look like everybody else in the room, but there's something special going on between us. You know, there's a bond that Christ instituted with all of us. Requires work on our part to say, yes, Lord, to respond. But that offer is irrevocable. It's permanent, just like our relationships in our families, permanent and irrevocable. And the beauty of this relationship isn't just limited to our families. No, it's to our brothers and sisters around us as well. So we need to be careful not to tarnish the image of God in our lives, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You know, and I was thinking about this, you know, I have to be careful. I can't just go to the local grocery store and give somebody the what's what and the what's for because they made me mad, especially if they deserve it. Yes, there's a time and a place for that, but probably not in the middle of a grocery store aisle, I will tell you that. So we need to be mindful. We are still the hands and feet of the Son of God this side of heaven. And it's a big responsibility for each of us to hold to that standard of holiness. We're not always going to get it right, but we need to strive in our journey to be at that place. You know, there's something that's been going on in this week that's been very painful for a number of folks, aside from Father Matt passing away earlier this week. The deacon community is also struggling. We found out that one of our brothers has inoperable pancreatic cancer. Very sad, and it's advanced. And so, of course, I'm feeling a little down, and I'm headed to the hospital to see him. And as I'm getting into the room, I'm like, gosh, what am I going to say? I mean, I've known him for years. I know what I should say, but it's different now. And so I get in the room, and something wonderful happened. He looked up, he saw me, he recognized me, and suddenly I felt like I was the one being blessed. I was immediately felt the grace, I felt peace. And you know, we sat down, we had a conversation, and as odd as this is, these two old deacons, we never talked about God directly, but God was present. That grace and that peace was abundant to both of us. And I think about that, you know, often since that time. And by the way, he's at home and he's resting. But think about those times in your lives where you've encountered, out of the blue, something you didn't expect, that grace, that peace. You know, there's chaos going around me, but I'm feeling different. I'm feeling okay. I would ask you to thank God for that. Thank God for that. Aside from these traumatic situations like I just described, when are there times that we can be in the presence of Christ, in the presence of God, feel the power of the Holy Spirit? Well, right here, the Eucharist. I recognize that there's some of our folks are homebound, they're watching from television. Through their televisions, and I'm so glad, I'm so blessed that you're here. But communion with Christ is the apex. And I would encourage you, if you're not able to come to Mass, we'll bring Jesus to you. Simply call Notre Dame office if you're local. If you're not local, call your local parish. Christ will come to you. He meets us where we are. So I'll leave you with this, my brothers and sisters. Let us look at Transfiguration Sunday as a reminder to seek out those moments in our day-to-day lives when we can say with assurance, God, the Father, the Son, Holy Spirit was present and evident. God bless each and every one of you.
Now let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Now let us bring our prayers and petitions before God, our Almighty Father.
For the Holy Father, the Vicar of Christ, may God continue to bless him with wisdom and strength in leading the Church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations, may God reveal his power, inspiring them in humble service to him and to the people in their care. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For those who wrestle with doubt, may the Father reveal the love of Christ and draw them home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For all gathered here, may God in his kindness enable us to hear and obey his voice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Father Matthew Reichen, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for all those who have died, may they enjoy eternal life in heaven and behold the face of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
Almighty God, as we celebrate the Feast of the Transfiguration, we ask you to grant us your inspiration so that as we lead our lives, we so exhibit our love for you and for our brothers and sisters, that we lead all those we meet back to you. We offer these in all our prayers through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities, and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Sanctify, O Lord, we pray, these offerings here made to celebrate the glorious transfiguration of your only begotten Son. And by his radiant splendor, cleanse us from the stain of sin through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he revealed his glory in the presence of chosen witnesses, and filled with the greatest splendor that bodily form which he shares with all humanity. The scandal of the cross might be removed from the hearts of his disciples, that he might show how, in the body of the whole church, is to be fulfilled what so wonderfully shone forth first in its head. And so, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Lawrence our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Father Matthew Ryan, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us share with one another a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ.
Amen.
The blood of Christ.
Amen.
And now, since we cannot have regular communion together, please pray with me this prayer so that we may have spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot receive you at this moment sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May the heavenly nourishment we have received, O Lord, we pray, transform us into the likeness of your Son, whose radiant splendor you willed to make manifest in his glorious transfiguration, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Well, again, as always, thank you for being here, and I hope you have a good and holy day and a good week, and we'll see you next Sunday.